Well, hello. Good morning. I am here to give you guys an update on my mug collection, which has admittedly got completely out of control. Storage is becoming a problem. And I'm starting to get out of that realm of it being very practical and now just being like, I may have one too many, but I want so many more. So let's get started on my mug collection update. This was from the last video, so don't worry about that one. I will link the older video down below, but you can also find it in our collections playlist on our channel. All right, so as you guys know, we just recently went to Disney World and we went to the character warehouse and we went to the parks. I wanted to share with you guys what we got there first, which you may have seen in some of our previous videos, which I will again link below, but you can also find them on our playlists on our channel. First things first is I got this guy, Squeak, Squeaker, Squeakin', is what's written on the back, from the character warehouse off of Vineland. I think I got him for $5, and I absolutely love him. My Kronk, because they just don't honestly have enough Emperor's New Groove stuff out, and really not enough that I like in a style that I like. Next up is my new Disney World mug. So this one has a really simplistic design, and on the inside you'll see it says Walt Disney World. But I like it because it's a representative of all four parks, and I just really love the design. If they had this in a t-shirt, I probably would have gotten the t-shirt over the mug, but they didn't. So I really wanted to get this mug. This one was actually given to me before we went to Disney World. So it's not technically from Disney World, but from Disneyland. I had a friend who was able to go to Galaxy's Edge before I was, and I really, really, I saw this mug on Instagram and I really wanted it. Oh my God. This one is the Jedi mug from, where did I get this?
I forgot.
Oh, this is the Jedi mug from the Antiquities store inside Galaxy's Edge. And it's only sold inside Galaxy's Edge. It's one of my larger mugs. As you can see, oh, it's my whole hand. Okay, I love it. Okay, so a little bit closer on the details. I love it because it's got like the rising suns and the moons, and of course the Jedi symbol. And it feels like stoneware, but it's not, and it's huge on the inside. And of course on the bottom, it gives you a big old Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. This is the last one. This mug is the last mug that I got at Disney World proper. I got this at Epcot because I walked in, and I'll link that video below as well, like the moment I saw this and I fell in love. And it is Remy's Ratatouille. It's La Ratatouille on the inside. And then Remy's right in the front, and this little handle is a spoon. Oh, I can't get over it. I can't. And on the bottom it just says, well, Disney World, of course. It was $16.95. It's a lot of money for this small of a cup. So it is of a similar size to my little diner cup from Disney Cruise Line. But it's slightly larger in the ounces for this one, but not much. But I love it because my pinky fits right into the little scoop. And oh my God. Like, these are the things that make me geek out and make my husband just like shake his head like, I don't understand it, but he does the same thing for pins, so we are even in that. But I do love me some Ratatouille. It's the chef hat, in case you didn't notice that before. It's his little chef hat, because he's a little chef. Next up is something that was actually gifted to me by my husband via a friend, our friend Callie. Hey, Callie. Thank you so much for ferrying this up from the Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween party. She got me a Hocus Pocus cauldron. You might remember in the previous video that I do already have a cauldron, but it's got one big old handle and it's very large. This one is almost exactly like my Hogwarts one, but look at this. Look at that. And then of course, the ladies. Oh, And the handles, of course, are just colored. The inside of it is very plain Jane, just black. And the very bottom actually has where it was bought from, which was only out for a very limited time this last year. Thank you so much, Callie, for this. And of course, my hubs, because he knows me and he knows how much I love these ladies. Now, the rest of these mugs were purchased from Shop Disney. So most of these were ordered. Some of them were found at the outlet stores, but for the most part, they all came from the Disney store. And the first one up is Ham from Toy Story. I love this guy. We got him at the outlet store. Actually, the same day that I did my last video about my mugs was the same day we purchased him, but he wasn't clean. He still has stickers on it, so I didn't add him into the video. So I've had him almost a year. Has it been almost a year I've been doing this?
Yep.
My gracious. Hey, only 14 in a year is a pretty good thing versus the, like, what was it, 27 last time? I actually don't drink out of Ham. I tend to use him for soups because he's on the larger side, but mostly because this is so wide, I've had, like, coffee come flying out the sides, and I look like I'm not able to properly handle beverages if I drink out of it because it's just really wide. Otherwise, it feels kind of weird to sip it from the front because I don't really feel like making out with Ham. He looks like how I look when I try to drink from him. Since we're on the Toy Story kick, this was a purchase by my mister to me. These are BoPeep's sheep. So these used to be part of her lamp, and I believe it's Billy, Goat, and Gruff. I know it's Billy and Gruff. I don't remember the middle one's name. So comment on below if you guys do know it, because I don't. But I just love that there's other stuff. Like, these are the stickers that are added to it in Toy Story 4 from other kids just, like, throwing stuff on it. And on the bottom, it does come up with a Disney Pixar. Let me get a closer look at these. I know I'm really rocky. I'm not great at showing things off. I do like using this mug, though, because the only downside is this goes against my rules. See these cavities on the inside of their heads? If coffee gets in there, it's almost impossible to clean them out. So it goes a little bit against one of my rules. And I'll go over those rules in a second. The next set that I have, which is an incomplete set, it's a set that I've been searching for the rest of them for a while because I missed out on buying one of the one that I really wanted out of it. It's the Villain set. So we have, first off, is Scar on the front, and on the back it says, "Forgive me for not leaping with joy." Yeah, leaping for joy, sorry. It's just black on the interior, but I do love the mug handle because it's his tail. You can kind of see the ridges there. And of course, it fits a pinky. It's like two to three fingers in a pinky. Or like two, yeah. So it's got this, like, kind of trapezoid looking shape to it. I really like this one. We got on sale for, I think, $6 at the outlet, because by the time I realized these were here, they were already at the outlet. So that's one of the reasons why we missed out on them. Next up is the Queen of Hearts. Queen of Hearts handle has this wonderful heart, which is really comfortable to hold. And on the back, it says, "Off with their heads." So you can see it's, like, real comfortable to hold this one. I like this one a lot. I've used this one a lot recently too, because Valentine's Day was recently, so why not be the Queen of Hearts? Next up is actually one that Matt just bought me, and I love it so much. And it's still brand new. It's still out in the stores as of the posting of this video, and I do love it. The only downside is that it's not microwavable because of the base. And that's the Animator's Collection mug. This one is so stinking adorable because look at all these baby princesses. Oh my god. I can't get over it. And it's just pink on the inside, nothing new. But the base is wooden. So with that wooden base, it unfortunately means that it can't be put into dishwasher, it can't be submerged, and it can't be put in the microwave, which is the only downside about this. And as you can see, mine actually is starting to get a little bit of a lip right here. It's not as tight as it. Oh no. Oh no. Well, that's a fun count. We're gonna have to glue this back later. Here you go, Matt. I just barely touched that. Did you hear it snap?
Yeah.
It's just the glue. This is one of the reasons why it's not microwavable or anything.
Yeah, the glue wasn't set right.
So be very careful with the wooden bottom ones. They're very cool. They really hold the heat very well, but they might snap off. All right, this one Matt bought me for Mother's Day last year. And he, quick side story. Matt and I try to break each other emotionally for most like events. We try to do it for our wedding. We try to do it for every birthday, every holiday. Like we try to like really, it sounds so mean to break someone emotionally, but we try to make each other cry in a good way. He did it this year though for me, for Mother's Day. He bought me the adventure book from Up. I really love Up. It's one of my favorite movies, especially the first 11 minutes. Oh my God. And then he got me this mug to go with it. So you see Russell, and then we got the house. I love it so much. It's one of the reasons why our logo is the three balloons, to be like me and Matt and our little man, each representative of a balloon. But yeah, he broke me with this. I was like crying instantly because he also filled the adventure book with moments of our life that we've gone through, like getting engaged at Disney World and our wedding and having our little boy and it's killing me. And finally, we have my newest set, which I need them to come out with more because I bought the only two there were, but I like need them to finish off the set. And that is these adorable Animator's collection of the villains. Look at how stinking cute she is. And on the inside at the top, it says scaring up a spell. How adorable. My little baby Maleficent. Oh, scaring up another spell. How flippin' adorable is she? And then this is kind of like reminiscent of like a dragon's tail, I think. Or maybe her staff hook. I actually quite haven't figured out what that is. But it's a really comfortable mug. It's not too big. It's on the larger side. But I love it. And then finally, my current favorite. So favorite, in fact, that just before I was making this video, I'd had like 4 cups of coffee in it. That's why I'm talking so fast. And it is my Ursula mug. Look at this, it's so cute. It says, what me scary? Is it? No, where is it? Oh, it's on the back of this. Sorry. It's my Ursula mug. Look at how stinking cute she is. And it's got her shell, the shell necklace over here, and it's just kind of elongated out. Super comfortable. And on the backside, me, scary. I love them more than anything. In fact, I love these more than the princess ones. The baby villains are more adorable in every way, and I flippin' love them. But these are the only two in the series so far. And they went from like the regular store, which we bought them at full price at $16.95, to the outlet store in like a month. So felt like kicking myself when I saw them at the outlet store and I was like, ding, ding. That being said, they need to have more of these. And you can see at the very bottom, it says Animator's Collection. I want more. I want more of these. So Disney, if you're listening and watching this, which I know you're not, but if you were, more, please. Start treating us like pin traders and we will totally trade mugs. Finally, this one's not mine. This is not my mug. This one was my Valentine's gift for Matt, which he actually chose himself. And that is Pirate Stitch. This came from the shop, Disney app. So Pirate Stitch on the backside has the Disney Cruise Line. This is from the cruise line. Which normally there's a lot of things on the cruise line that you can't get once you get home. But this one was on the app and he flippin' loves it. He's actually used this one probably more often than his Coco one and his other Stitch one that we were gifted from Effie. Hey, he's been drinking out of it all week. So there we have 14 new mugs in the last year since I've made the previous video. Year-ish since I made the previous video. I might have a problem. I didn't think I had a problem before, but I might have a problem now. Yeah, that problem is storage. That's the only problem I have. Buying these is not my problem. So I'm the crazy mug lady, and I thought you guys would enjoy having an update of my collection. Oh, I never went over my rules. Okay, so when looking at mugs, I have like this internal thought process. Usually it is an obsessive sounding crazy person list, but my mugs have to meet three criteria, and they're gonna sound so wrong. The criteria of the mugs is they can't be over 20 ounces, because then it's just way too big. I don't drink coffee fast enough for anything over 20 ounces. There's a couple out there that are like 24 ounces and 32. They're just huge. I do have a few in my collection that go above that rule, like my Baymax one from my old video goes above that rule. So it has to be under 20 ounces, preferably about 12. Second rule is the handle has to fit at least two fingers and have a placeholder for my pinky and my thumb. For example, this one is probably the only one that goes against that rule, but the whole thing is dainty. It's when the mug is large and there's not a good handle for my hand that I don't like doing it. Like, there's still a lot of room. I could put two fingers in here if I wanted to, but I don't usually. It's when it's a larger one. So for example, something I love is this one, right? This one is you can fit three fingers in here, and there's a little lip right here for your pinky or just underneath. And there's a holder for your thumb up here. It's nice and flat. There's a lot of ones out there that have really ornate handles, but the handles are too hard to hold. The whole point of having a mug is that it's practical and useful. If I can't use it, I'm not gonna buy it. And then the third rule is it can't have too many places for food and or drink to hide. This is one of the mugs that kind of goes against that, but I rarely fill it up high enough to fill into these cavities. It's because it needs to be washable, because I do use these. So if it's not washable, I don't want it, you know? There were a couple Stitch ones that I was thinking about buying Matt that I didn't get because the inside was so molded that it would have been impossible for us to clean it out properly. So yeah, as you've seen from the video, almost all of my mugs follow those rules. My personal favorite one is this one because I have a big hand, so I don't have to hold it like this. I'm actually able to fit through both. This is probably my favorite one. I hope you guys enjoyed an update of my mugs, and are there any mugs that you guys might have that you think I'd like? Do you guys have any mugs that are your absolute favorites or characters or things like that? Let me know in the comments below. Other than that, you can check out all of our videos on our channel, as always. We love you guys. I can't believe we've been doing this for as long as we have. And I really hope you guys have a great week. With that being said, we'll see you guys on our next adventure. Bye!